Hey there, thanks for tuning in to another Pentest-Tools.com video. I'm Iulian, software engineer, and I want to share with you three XSS scenarios you can replicate for your POCs. You can find all these scenarios and seven others in the most read article on the Pentest-Tools.com blog in the past 5+ years. There's a link to it in the description. At the end of this video, you'll know how to hijack a user's session, launch DOM-based attacks, and scan internal ports. So let's get right into it. XSS attacks come in three forms: reflected XSS attacks, persistent XSS attacks, and DOM-based XSS attacks. We are going to explore one type of each. So this is the blog article. This is an example of a reflected XSS attack. The first attack scenario we'll be looking at involves stealing a user's session cookie in order to make requests on behalf of the user. You can access the cookie from JavaScript code if the HTTP-only flag is missing, so be sure to always set it in. In DVWA, it is missing, so we can show how the attack scenario works. We will be using the browser's alert box in order to print a message with the cookie. The examples in the blog article are made to be copy and pasted, so you can just copy the code into the browser URL bar if you open the DVWA app. So you can see that we got the session cookie. In a real pen test, you will have to exfiltrate the session cookie in order to be able to use it. To do that, one of the easiest things is to create a new image in the browser DOM, set the source attribute to the IP of a server that you control. The browser makes a request to that server, giving you the cookie. Always remember to set the HTTP-only flag. The next attack on our list is the DOM-based attack. DOM-based attacks are more elusive than reflected or persistent XSS attacks. All XSS attacks come from the client side and involve the DOM to some extent. The root cause of the issue resides in how the browser JavaScript handles the user input. DOM-based attacks have two main entities: sources and sinks. XSS sources are the places in a web application where user-controllable data can enter the application and potentially be executed as part of the page's content. This is how we introduce the malicious data. XSS sinks are locations in a web application's code where the user-controllable data from the sources is used without proper validation or sanitization. We need this because they are the pieces of code that execute our malicious code. The last attack scenario we will be reviewing is the port scanning example from the article. It uses a stored XSS in order to test whether a port is open on the server. In a real-life attack, you can use JavaScript to make an ad hoc port scanner, but in this example, we will be using the image tag. We saw how to insert IPs in the source attribute of an image. Well, we can also include the port. This gives us an opportunity. If we know a certain image should be present on the server, for example, we either see it on the website or look for usual images like favicon.eco, we can try to request it through the port. If the image appears on the website, it means that the port is open. Otherwise, we can't tell for certain. Of course, in a real pen test, you will want to find a way to exfiltrate the results. If you use JavaScript, you should add a callback function that maybe uses the fetch API to get to your server. And that's it. In this video, you learned how to hijack a user's session, launch DOM-based attacks, and scan internal ports. If you're still curious to learn more, you can find even more information about this topic in our blog article with the same name, which you can find linked below in the description box. I hope you found this video on XSS attacks useful and you'll begin to implement the things you've learned here today. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to let us know in the comment section below. Thanks for joining me today and have a great day.